Welcome to another edition of What Sport Is That? I'm your host, Ms. Cameron. Today we will look at a sport that combines speed, strength, power, teamwork, and dragons. Dragons? Yes, it's true. Today's sport is called Dragon Boat Racing. A dragon boat is 40 feet long and nearly 4 feet at its widest point. A dragon boat holds 20 paddlers who sit side by side in 10 rows, plus a drummer and a steersperson. Paddlers, not rowers, compete in races that are 200 meters, 500 meters, 1,000 meters, or 2,000 meters long. Now let's talk about the science of dragon boat racing. First, let's take a look at a dragon boat race. It's clear that the boats are moving in a rectilinear fashion. First boat across the line wins. But watch closely at an individual paddler. Notice how they pull their paddle backward and then snap it forward over and over again? Well, that's an example of translation. So how do you win a dragon boat race? Well, you need to generate a lot of force with every stroke. First, the athlete must rotate their torso to place their paddle in the water. This rotation generates a huge torsion force on the athlete's torso. As the paddler places the paddle in the water and pulls the paddle back, the blade generates a compression force between the water, which moves the boat forward. At the same time, the athlete's top hand and blade are pulling in one direction, while the water is pushing in another direction, creating a flexion force on the shaft of the paddle. The moving boat slices through the water, generating a shearing force between the boat and the water around it. Here is the free body diagram of a dragon boat stroke. Gravity and the weight of the boat combined with the weight of the paddlers push the boat down into the water. At the same time, the water pushes back up on the boat, and the athletes also must exert a downward pressure with the blade of their paddle against the water, which also helps to push the boat up and out of the water. The force generated by the athletes push the boat forward, but the water creates resistance on the bow, that's the front of the boat, and pushes the boat backward. At the same time, there's also a force of the wind pushing the boat backward, which is especially true on a windy day. Athletes must generate a lot of force to move the boat forward. Sport equipment has changed a lot over the years, and dragon boat paddles are no exception. A dragon boat paddle is made of three parts: the handle, the shaft, and the blade. The shaft of the paddle may not be bent, and the blade must be perfectly smooth. A dragon boat paddle must look the same from the front and the back. A traditional paddle has a height of 62 inches and a shaft length of 45 inches. Paddlers refer to this paddle size as 45 inches. It weighs 600 grams, plus or minus 20 grams. A traditional paddle is made out of wood, so its raw material is wood and its material source is plant-based. Since dragon boat athletes come in all shapes and sizes, modern dragon boat paddles come in all shapes and sizes too, from a 42-inch paddle to a 51-inch paddle. A modern paddle is much lighter, it only weighs 380 grams instead of 600 grams, and is made out of carbon fiber. Not only is carbon fiber lighter, but it's also less flexible, which allows the athlete to pull more water with each and every stroke. A carbon fiber paddle's raw material is carbon, which is a mineral. A dragon boat is human-powered instead of being powered by a motor. That means the athletes need to generate the energy to move the boat forward. In this picture, you can see the athletes generating potential energy when their paddles are in the air and the boat is moving forward. As soon as the boat starts to slow down, the athletes convert that potential energy into kinetic energy by driving their paddles back into the water and pulling back. Simple machines are used all over the place, and dragon boat racing is no exception. The bottom of the boat is a wedge, which allows the boat to cut through the water. The paddle and the athlete create a third-class lever with the fulcrum at the handle, the load at the blade in the water, and the effort being applied by the bottom arm near the top of the blade. Lastly, paddlers need to have strong backs. One way to train their backs is to do an exercise called the lat pull down. In this exercise, a cord is attached to a weight and passed through pulleys. As the athlete pulls down, the weight goes up. So what countries dominate this sport? Germany often places in the top three spots. China is widely recognized as the best sprinters in the world, and Canada typically dominates the 2,000 meter. The two countries, Canada and China, typically fight out the last two podium positions. Athletes change from year to year, and some athletes get the opportunity to represent Canada more than once. Your very own Miss Cameron, that's me, has had the honor of representing Canada at five different world championships, winning 19 medals, six of them gold. So hope you enjoyed Dragon Boat Racing. We'll see you next time on What Sport Is That, where we're taking a look at Bosu Ball Volleyball. Stay tuned.